Those who find it difficult to understand that the American people voted for Donald Trump get over it, because he's president of the United States. And what I would say for all of us here, and this actually includes myself, is that we have to ask ourselves, why is it that people felt so left behind that they've made the democratic decisions that they've had, which we think we can't understand, some of us. How can you possibly vote for Brexit? How can you possibly vote for Donald Trump? And the fact is that the people have. These were the forgotten people. And just like we had the forgotten people in the United Kingdom, there are the forgotten people in the United States of America. We may not like some of the things that he says, and I certainly don't like some of the things that he said in the past. But I do respect the fact that he stood on a platform which he is now delivering. He is going to go down in history as being roundly condemned for being the only politician to deliver on his promises. I know that we can all go back and talk to the people that we know in our own little echo chambers, and that we hear are the same things, but the fact is that there were 61 million people who voted for Donald Trump. And when we stand up in this country and then condemn him for being racist, and I've seen no evidence of that, I have seen no evidence of him being racist, or that they attack him in an unseemly way, we're actually attacking the American people, the 61 million people who voted for Donald Trump. If they wanted more of the same or the usual stuff, well, that was on the ballot paper. But they decided, by the majority of states on the Electoral College, as it works, that they wanted Donald Trump.